Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your
spirit. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. May the venerable intercession of the glorious Virgin Mary come to our aid, we pray, O Lord, so that fortified by her protection, we may reach the mountain which is Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the land in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. It shall not be eaten raw or boiled, but roasted whole, with its head and shanks and inner organs. None of it must be kept beyond the next morning. Whatever is left over in the morning shall be burned up. This is how you are to eat it. With your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will take the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord.
I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord.
and I will call upon the name of the Lord.
I will take the cup of salvation and call the name of the Lord.
Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds.
We shall take the cup of salvation and call the name of the Lord.
To you will I offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I repeated in the presence of all his people.
I will take the cup of salvation and call the name of the Lord.
Alleluia! Disciples were hungry, and he began to pick the heads of grain and eat them. When the Pharisees saw this, they said to him, "See, your disciples are doing what is unlawful to do on the Sabbath." He said to them, "Have you not read what David did when he and his companions were hungry? How he went into the house of God and ate the bread of offering, which neither he nor his companions, but only the priests, could lawfully eat? Or have you not read in the law that on the Sabbath the priests serving in the temple violate the Sabbath and are innocent? I say to you, something greater than the temple is here. If you knew what is meant, I desire mercy, not sacrifice, you would have not condemned these innocent men, for the Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, from the book of Exodus, one of those first five books of the Bible, which we know as the Torah, or the Pentateuch, how beautifully is described a foreshadowing of the Eucharist, the Passover of the Lord. Isn't this the Passover of the Lord? The sacrifice of the Lamb slain for our sins, passing over from death into life, right? Baptism is a Passover, isn't it? Passing over from death into life. The death of sin, original sin is removed for infants. Sin, original and those committed after, for adults who are baptized later in life. How beautiful we see the Passover of the Lord among us right now. And in the book of Exodus, it's beautifully foreshadowed of the institution of the Eucharist, about the lamb slain, about the blood posted on the door lintels, around the door, so that the angel may pass and not inflict death upon those who have taken from the lamb. How beautiful that foreshadowing is for you and me, because Christ promised, "Whoever eats the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood shall not die, but have eternal life." And so death passes because the blood is not on the lintel of a door, but on the lintel of our lips. You and I understand completely the necessary for participation in the Eucharist, the food of everlasting life, the food of salvation, the nourishment of the soul. It's also the medicine that you and I need for the journey of life, don't we? after sacramental confession, the prescription is to take this medicine. Take this medicine and cling on to that medicine and receive it as often as possible if you want to live. This is what the divine physician has asked us. Even the psalmist today in the psalm, I will take the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. In the Gospel of St. Matthew, Jesus reminds all of us that he is the Lord of the Sabbath. For the Christians, it is Sunday to keep holy the Sabbath day, the Lord's day, and to make sure that we take time to gather around the altar of the Lord's cross, to listen to his word, and to allow that word to be digested as well into our very body and soul, and to partake in the Eucharist, to digest the Eucharist, and to make that part of our way of life. Taking the time just to rest is so important. We talked about this the other day, to rest. Sunday is a good time to rest, isn't it? It's the Lord's day, to rest in him, to take the time to give him time, to read, reflect, and also to spend time with family, to enjoy the beauty of the labor of our days, our 6 days, to enjoy it, and to be with one another. Everything that we do should be leading toward that, right? That day, that holy day that we call the Sabbath, leading us to the sacraments. Today the Church celebrates the optional memorial of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. We've all heard of this title, Our Lady, haven't we? July the 16th, as we celebrate her day. It's a beautiful day. It really goes back to the Old Testament with Elijah. And of course, Elijah being on the mountain. Even the mountain is a foreshadowing of Christ, who is really the voice of God, divine revelation coming among us. All the prophets would go to the mountain to converse with God, to plead with him for the people. At that time, there was a severe drought and there was much in need of rain. And when Elijah went up there, he saw an image of a woman with child. How beautiful that image was of Our Lady. Mount Carmel is, of course, situated in Israel, in the northern part. If you want to look at Israel, easy, this is how I remember it. I don't know how you remember, but it's very easy for me to remember. God sent Jesus. Now I say that because Galilee, Samaria, Jerusalem. That's an easy way to remember that. And so in the area of Galilee and Samaria is Mount Carmel. The Carmelite fathers and brothers were founded upon that mountain, and they also call upon Elijah. And so beautiful is this revelation of Our Lady appearing, even in the Old Testament, because we don't hear about that much, do we? Again, I mentioned the foreshadowing of the Eucharist and the foreshadowing of Our Blessed Lady. So you can see how the Old Testament is a foreshadow of the New Testament. See how they both work. I hope you're saying to yourself, yes, Father, both and not either or. You're right. How beautifully that all works together. And the community of the Carmelites were founded
obviously Carmel, Carmelites, this beautiful religious order. Our Lady appeared to St. Simon Stock. Have you ever heard of St. Simon Stock? Our Lady gave him the scapular. St. Simon Stock was the superior general, the head of the order. Remember we talked about at one time Bonaventure was the head of the OFMs, the Order of Friar Minors? Well, here St. Simon Stock. And Our Lady gave him a scapular, named after the place in which it goes over the body, the scapula. And it's placed over the scapula in the front and in the back as a mantle of Mary, her protection over us. And there's two panels, one in the front and one in the back, always protecting the body so that no evil may enter the soul. It's so nice to have these sacramentals, but we must be very careful that they're not good luck charms. Because there could be a little bit of religiosity that creeps in to religion that takes these items that we call sacramentals, you know, scapulars, rosaries, statues, crucifixes, holy water, as good luck charms. And that is not what they're intended to be. They're supposed to be, like their name says, sacramentals, leading us to the sacraments, and to use them properly, to use them as an aid for us to really dive in more into the spiritual life of our Catholic faith, and to use it properly. It is that those who die wearing the scapular will not enter into the fires of hell. Okay, let's talk about that. Again, it's not a good luck charm. So you can't be leading a life contrary to the gospel and say, well, as long as I wear this, then I don't care. I'll go right to heaven. No, you won't. No, you won't. It has to be always in union with the Christian life. Mass, confession, works of charity. It's both and, not either or. It's an understanding of what all these sacramentals mean. They're not decorations. They're not like rabbit foots or good luck charms. But they're to be used in conjunction with the sacrament, leading us to the sacrament. So on this day, dedicated to Our Lady, and the Carmelites had a special reverence to Our Lady because of this apparition to Elijah and to St. Simon Stock, and how that carried out even to this day, all these years later, of Our Lady's love and protection for all of us. After communion, I will bless anybody who has a new scapular or anybody who wants to be enrolled into the confraternity of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Now, what does that mean? Well, the confraternity has certain prayers and certain ways that the members should undertake. So you need to look at that. You need to research that, or the best way to do it is probably in this world, is Google, to make sure you understand what that means to be a member of the confraternity of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. And that would be wonderful. Men and women who are not members of religious communities like us, the religious communities offer to lay members to be lay associates. I'm sure you've heard of that, right? The Carmelites have lay associates, the Franciscans have lay associates, and other communities have lay associates that they're not members of the order, but they're lay people, men and women, married, single, even ordained, that are not members of their community, but they are associates of that community, and they follow a way of life for the layperson. So the confraternity is connected to that. May this celebration of this optional memorial of Our Lady of Mount Carmel truly inspire us and our world as we continue to, of course, follow the law of the Sabbath. For He is the Lord of the Sabbath, and that is the central day, the day of worship, the day of Eucharist, the day of acts of love and charity that inspire us for the week. May God continue to inspire us to be members of His body living in this world.
After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For the church and our leaders, may we be blessed with wisdom and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of responsibility and power, may our just and merciful God guide them in their service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle to see beauty or goodness in their lives, may the truth of God's love and care for them shine forth in their hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For we who are gathered here, may our hearts grow in holiness and reverent awareness of the gift of God's presence in this most holy sacrifice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they be welcomed into the light of the kingdom and see the wonders of God face to face. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, James Osmond, Dottie Ott, Matthew Pellegrini, Suzanne DeSantis, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Dorothy Latina, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish and for the Carmelite order. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
For our
intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of her Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on this memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Carmel. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, she brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, the minions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God,
as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed is the womb of the Virgin Mary, which bore the Son of the Eternal Father.
Thank you.
this time, everyone, I'll have the blessing of the brown scapular. And then after the blessing of the brown scapular, we'll have the investiture of the brown scapular for those who wish to be enrolled into the confraternity of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Please stand. Show us, O Lord, and have mercy, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come unto you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The blessing of scapulars. Let us pray. O Lord Jesus Christ, Savior of the human race, sanctify by your power these scapulars, which for love of you and for the love of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, your servants will wear devoutly, so that through the intercession of the same Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and protected against the evil spirit, they persevere until death in your grace, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The investiture of the brown scapular. Receive this blessed scapular and ask the Most Holy Virgin that by her merits you may wear it without stain. May it protect you from all harm and bring you to everlasting life. Amen. Place the scapular over your head. By the power granted to me, I admit you to a share in all the spiritual works performed by the merciful help of Jesus Christ, by the religious order of Mount Carmel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth, bless you, whom he has pleased to receive you into the confraternity of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. We beg her to crush the head of the ancient serpent at the hour of your death, and to enter into possession of your everlasting inheritance. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech you, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So yesterday it was announced by the bishops of Pennsylvania and the diocese within that state. Archbishop Perez is the Metropolitan Archbishop of the state of Pennsylvania, so he works with conjunction with all the bishops of Pennsylvania, and they have announced yesterday that the dispensation will be lifted, and that will happen on the solemnity of the Assumption of Our Lady, which is both a Sunday and a holy day. It's a two-for-oneer. It's a Sunday and a holy day, all wrapped up into one. So it's Sunday, August 15th. That dispensation from not attending Mass because of the pandemic these last, 17, 18 months, will be lifted on the solemnity of the Assumption on August the 15th. They also state that always when someone is ill, someone who's compromised in such a physical way that they do not want to be around people, that has always been the case of a dispensation for those people, right? I remember that as a kid. So nothing changed for that particular. So for those who are sick and for those who are compromised physically, there is, of course, a dispensation from not attending the Sabbath, the holy day of the Lord, on Saturday afternoon or Sunday. But the dispensation for
this past pandemic for the last 17 months, I guess, is for it to be lifted. That means all baptized Catholics are to attend Mass on Sundays and holy days of obligation, which will begin, of course, on August the 15th. If they do miss, it will be sacramental confession must be